back on him in the whip, that's foreign. Drip drop on him with a chick, that's gorgeous.
What would you say to the person that says the artist makes the beat?
That's the guy I want to work with. Yeah, that's the guy I want to work with. Because like I said, I want a beat that allows me to breathe on it. And I want a beat that allows me to do what I do on it. Now, and I don't know if he can agree with me or not, but with that said, you have to be an artist that knows your voice and knows what beats work for you. You know, because I've gone through the process of trying to force myself and force a different voice on a beat that never really worked for me. But because you feel like you could do it, you push the envelope a bit. But it's just so much easier on yourself when you know yourself and you could just hear a beat and be like, yeah, I know. Like the process we went through before we came in, you guys gave us the opportunity to choose a beat for a little little session we'll have a little later. And it's like, we went through about 5 to 10. And the second we heard one, we're like, yeah, that one works. Mm-hmm. Meanwhile, all the other ones we know right away. I press play and no more than 2 seconds in, he's like, nah.
Next. I saw that.
You know what I'm saying? So once you learn yourself, the process becomes a little easier every time.
So what would you say to, and this seems to be a theme with different artists, what would you say if the person says, like, you need to be diverse? So you were just saying this now. Yeah. You don't want to take a beat that is not something you feel like you would be good on. Mm-hmm. So what about the people that say, like, no, you should try to change it up and do something because you want to hit different markets?
Good question, man. Good question. Aeon, handle that one because he's Mr. Versatile. You know, real talk.
I feel like, there's only, in my opinion, there's only so much you can do, man. There's only so much. Like, you're not going to hear me on a rock song, but nothing like that. So,
right.
That's facts.
I'm not, you know what I'm saying? Like, what he said, like, you just have to know yourself. Mm-hmm. Like,
that's facts.
I know that I'm gonna shine on these type of beats, but maybe on this one I might not. Just like, maybe that's not my thing.
Mm-hmm.
Like, maybe it's just, I just make music that I like, innit?
Mm-hmm.
So like, I like different genres. So the genres that I do like, one time I'm gonna fuck it up, I'm gonna do my thing on it, because mm-hmm. I just like that sound. So I'm gonna just, but if it's something I don't like, then I'm gonna just be shit on that record or whatever, because I don't like that type of music. I'm making it, but I don't even like it. So mm-hmm. like,
and yo, real talk, the challenge as an artist and as a rapper is to be able to not let those type of guys change what you do. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can't let a guy saying that to you all of a sudden make you want to switch up what you do. If you know that's not what you do, that's not what you do.
Exactly.
My music, we don't make our music for everybody. You know what I'm saying? We know we got a little niche market that's really going to mess with it, and then we got the other people that just like good music mm-hmm. that are gonna mess with it. Cause there's no question we make good music.
Right.
Whether you mess with it and it's your thing and you're bumping it in your whip or not, that's up to you.
Yeah.
But for anyone that appreciates and likes good music, we'll get plays. Mm-hmm. There's no question. But we don't make our music for everybody. We just make it the best we can. We make it as genuine and organic as we can. And the rest of it falls into play. You know?
And I think there's something to be said about being authentic to your core group of people. So another interesting thing, we were having this discussion about, you look at the Drake and Pusha T beef, right?
Yeah.
So people say Pusha T is not relevant. He's not on the level of Drake.
Mm.
So the beef doesn't make sense. Drake is killing him because Drake is doing all sorts of different genres of music, right?
Yeah.
But I think Pusha T stays to his own and stays true to his own.
Yeah.
Is there something to 100. Be said about that?
Yeah, 100. Like, he knows his lane. He's not going to be on no Afrobeat or no.
I could never hear that.
Absolutely.
I could never hear that, you know. But yo, also in terms of the relevancy, like, or the relevance, like, yo, Pusha has cemented himself enough to be able to not have to be currently in the moment super hot relevant for him to be able to put up a good battle against Drake. Like, the reality is, it's arguable that he won that battle, relevant or not.
Mm-hmm.
And it's because, just like Aeon and you said, he didn't change, he didn't switch up. He did unapologetically push a T, bodied some beats. Which one was the one he bodied on his album?
Oh, I don't even remember that. I know what you're talking
about. Yo, honestly, man, I can't believe I forgot. But that was the first clapback, and that was probably the best one in my opinion. But that one was just like, ugh. That's his ad lib. So, you know, I'll say, like, especially with that beef specifically, whether he was relevant or not, When it came time to press record and for when it hit the wax, it was fire.
You're right.
Back on him in the whip, that's foreign. Drip drop on him with a chick, that's gorgeous.